And from the Fort Wayne Coliseum, I'm Vinnie Lopes alongside my Comets beat reporter Blake Sebring as we saw the Comets lose to the Wichita Thunder 4-3 in Game 4 and for a few days at least push off the opportunity for the Comets to win the CHL Championship. Now, Blake, I know you harped on this in our postgame show when the Comets were able to win Game 3 to take a 3-0 series lead. First 10 minutes, Game 4 was going to be critical. Comets were going to likely come out tight and Wichita was able to take advantage of that.
Yeah, for some reason this team has never responded really, really well in front of huge crowds. They've always played really tight and they're tentative and they were anxious. I mean, the penalties that they took were not penalties they normally have been taking, a lack of discipline. They were too fired up, if possible. I mean, they were trying to win the game in the first 10 minutes instead of get through the first 10 minutes.
Yeah, and you talk about the Comets, a lot of what you'll hear in the next couple days is missed opportunities. Comets, six pipes in the game, including one in the final second. You know, quarter inches one way or another, and this is a completely different game.
You know, it's kind of funny. You'd worry about this, except that's this team. You know, I mean, that's the way they do things. They don't do it the easy way. And I really expect them to be totally relaxed Monday and win quite big, really. I just think they'll just forget it and play. And I think Nick Boucher might even get a shutout on Monday night. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me in the least.
Yeah, and talking about the Comets team this year, you know, it just seems, you know, throughout this year, they just don't like doing anything easy. They always like to make it a little bit harder. So it kind of falls into the mantra of them playing in Game 5.
And you know, and it's kind of great is because it'll set them up perfectly mentally. I mean, they'll just relax and they won't have the same expectations, you know, to win the game in the first 5 minutes. They'll relax and just play. And when they do that and just follow their systems, they're fine. And I really expect them to win big on Monday. And I thought, I know, give Wichita a ton of credit. The Thunder showed up tonight.
Yeah. Well, and one of the players who really showed up for the Thunder, their backup goalie, Brian Hogan, comes into the game, or started Game 3, gave up 7 goals, bounced back Game 4, had 34 saves tonight. I mean, it's a little too early to say that Hogue Sanity's coming in and it's going to sweep through. But, you know, you got to give the guy a lot of credit for
sure.
The performance they had.
And I thought he gained confidence throughout the game. I thought his teammates gained more confidence in him. And you could see the excitement in them that they were laying out to block shots more and making more sacrifices than they had been earlier in the series, too. It's like I said, that was the Thunder we've been expecting to see for the first three games.
Yeah. Now, Blake, Game 5 is going to be here at the Coliseum on Monday. If the Comets don't win, it's going back to Kansas. So with that said, is Monday a must-win for the Comets?
No, not at all, because every time they've gotten in trouble this year, where have they gone to get healthy? They've gone on the road. So, you know, it would not surprise me in the least, but I really expect the Comets to win big on Monday.
Yeah, well, it should be an exciting series, and that game is going to be Monday night here at the Coliseum. Well, that's going to do it for us here. That's Blake Sebring. I'm Vinnie Lopes. Be sure to go to news-sentinel.com for all your Comets coverage.
See you Monday.